Immortals. John and Steve, what a night it's been, and indeed what a championship it's been. Ronnie says he might not come back. Do you believe him?
Not in the slightest. He loves the game too much. At the moment, he'll be tired after playing. It's a big 17 days. No matter whether you're better than the rest of the field, it's still a big effort to win here. And he'll have a few days off in the summer, and he'll go and relax, and he'll come back ready to play next year.
You know, Steve, it's very interesting. Ronnie, at the age of 32, is the oldest man to have won this title for 22 years since Joe Johnson. How many more could he achieve?
Well, I think there's a possibility of more. I mean, there are so many good players around. There's only one tournament a year that's the World Championship. But I think four is very realistic, and so is five. And it depends down to Ronnie, really, how much he decides to want to play the game. I do, to some degree, agree with John that, you know, I think Johnny will be back next, Ronnie will be back next year. But it does give our authorities a slight dilemma in the fact there's a disciplinary hearing coming up.
Indeed.
Sometime during the summer. And it puts a bit of pressure on that particular hearing to see what happens. But generally, he's a crowd favourite. Well, they'd love him to come back.
He's going to lose a few pounds at that disciplinary hearing, I suspect. But in general terms, Steve and John, what's different about Ronnie since his victories in 2001 and 2004? What's better about his game?
I don't think there's anything too much better than that. He was always tremendously talented. I just think he's had a great focus all year. He's been concentrating on the job in hand. He's turned up at the tournament. He's been very professional. I mean, the last 2 weeks, he's been a credit to himself and a credit to the game. And that's all he ever needs to be. No more, no less. Turn up, play your best. And if he does, that's what happens. He lifts trophies up.
He seems to have found a real degree of personal contentment and peace in his life.
Yes, and certainly that shows on the table. And I think he's shown great patience throughout this tournament. He was in a tough spot against Stephen Hendry, and he showed great patience in that department. And generally, I think he sort of seems to be a lot calmer on the table. But he obviously still has a dilemma of whether he's enjoying himself enough. But, I mean, he seems to be at home on the table, and that's the most important part. I think if he loses that part of his life, then perhaps he will be a bit lost. So it's best to stay as a snooker player.
Indeed. Ali Carter, did he just run out of gas, or what are the lessons he will have learned from this final in particular, John?
He ran out of gas. No, there's no way about it. I mean, he wasn't just missing pot. He was missing his dressing room, wasn't he, in the last couple of days. He's had a fantastic couple of weeks. It's been a massive learning curve for him. He's never been this far. He's never played in a tournament like this before to get to that stage. You know, best of 19s, best of 25s. He's done fantastically well. He can be very proud of himself and go back, and he knows a lot more about it now.
He does. And just thinking back to an experience you suffered at the hands of this man a few years ago. You were dropped by him in the final, and you came back and won a couple of years later.
You've got no idea how difficult the tournament this is to win. And it was such an eye-opener for me the first time. It was great to come back and win again. He'll have so much more experience than this.
You know, when I look back on this championship, Steve, I wonder how we'd characterise it, because for me it's certainly been one of the most aggressive, certainly one of the most potable championships. They've gone for everything.
It certainly has. I think aggression's been the order of the day. Stephen Hendry, halfway through the tournament, said that safety play is sort of underrated, or overrated in many ways. And you've got to look at a new breed of players coming through. You've got to be very attacking to get anywhere in the game. But you've still got to have a good balance to your game. You've got to be in control of yourself. And I think Ali Carter just lost a little bit of control.
Now, the other thing with Ali Carter, he gets a little bit of ring craft, and he'll know from watching the DVDs of the video. When he gets down and watches this, a little bit more ring craft in his game, he'll be a winner. That's the only thing that's missing.
Well, we talked about it being an aggressive championship, and 2 1-4-7s and numerous attempts prove that. But it's not just been about maximum entertainment on the table. There's been plenty of it as well over the last 17 days here in the Crucible Theatre.
I've started. No, I haven't.
Just what you need, a nice smelly sock.
I'm trying. Davis's hair was never that colour, John, was it?
Oh, who cares? I haven't got a clue.
Lyle! I'm with Sam, my husband. I've met you. And you know what? He'll know who you are.
That is one of the all-time great flukes.
Well, it wasn't a fluke. It was, I went for the bump, I went for the pot, potted the red and hit the red on the way back and knocked it in the middle. So, you know, it goes to show the commentators ain't got no knowledge, do they, if they can't see the shots.
Stole stick.
State your name.
The great W2.
Andrew.
I've never listened to you, Woody. I'm not going to start now.
Stop me now, I'm having such a good time. Oh. Don't stop me now. Just give me a call. Don't stop me now. I'm having a good
time. Don't stop me now. I'm having a good time. I could lose to anybody, I could lose to you. Maybe not, but close.
You know, I couldn't have put it better myself, Ronnie. And that reminds me, after the last couple of years, after midnight we've finished in these finals, nice to get an early start, an early finish this time, do you think, guys?
Yeah, absolutely.
Time for a drink, don't you think?
About your time to buy and all, I think.
Be about time as well.
Steve, John, pleasure. Thank you so much for your excellent company as ever over the last 17 days. Well, that's just about it. Thanks to the whole crew here in the Crucible. They've worked extremely hard. Indeed, so have you guys. Thank you very much. But that's it. It's time for Ali, Ronnie, and everyone else to take the long rest. Bye-bye for now.